Good day everybody, this tutorial will be about block planar failure. So we're gonna look at rock mass, but you can also apply it to soil material, soil mass. So it's gonna be the same setup. You will see that this part, big chunk of block, it's unstable, so it will probably go downward, down the slope. So why it's gonna go down the slope? Because of the gravity force. Gravity force comes from the weight of this rock mass. So why it's still stable? It's because of this shear strength. So shear strength will try to keep this block up on the slope. The shear strength comes from the strength of the rock mass material. And what we use for this particular case, we use more Coulomb failure criteria when we use friction angle and cohesion. So we look at safety factor, and in this particular case for safety factor, we're going to look at the ratio between the shear strength of rock mass. You see we have here cohesion and we have friction angle, and we're going to compare it to the shear stress action on this block that will try to push it downwards. So in this case we're going to look at the weights. You see we have a unit weight here and we have the height of the slope, and also shear stress depends on the inclination. So you see all these functions of sine and different angles. So angles comes here, it's shown here, this is I, so that will be the angle of the slope or face of the slope, and this one is theta, it's the angle of this failure plane. So you see this is the failure plane and this part is stable, so it's not gonna move. This going to be not rock slide, so rock slide, right? So this part gonna be moved. So the moving will be along this what we call failure plane, and we need to know the inclination of that. So let's see how we can solve this problem. We're going to look at actually I would call it a simplified setup. They are more difficult setups when we have also groundwater and we have some tension cracks here on the top. But we're going to look at this one. This is actually pretty handy, useful. It will give you quick estimation of the safety factor. And this is the formula that we use. And this is something, this text of the problem is something that you can get during site investigation. You can measure the height of the slope. It's 12 meters. So then we know that there is a potential failure plane. And we know that the strength of the rock mass material along this failure plane has very small cohesion, basically it's close to zero, and it still has some friction angle about 33 degrees. We can measure the plane inclination, so in this case it's a dip, which is 42 degrees, so this will be 42 degrees theta, right? And then we can also measure the inclination of the slope face. It is 65 degrees, so this angle I will be 64, right? So it should be steeper. So we're also given some data on the unit weight, dry condition, so probably there is no water. We need to determine the safety factor. Okay. So basically we're given everything, so we're just going to put the numbers in the formula and do the calculation. So safety factor is so on top we have strength, we have cohesion it's 10, then angle it's a sine of I, what's going to be 64 degrees, right? In this case, we're going to use cohesion in kPa because we use a unit weight also in kilonewtons, so we just try to keep the same units, right? You can change it to MPa, then you just need to put it as 0.01 MPa, right? So, but I think the best way is just to keep it as it is in kPa. So here, at the bottom, we're going to put unit weight, which is 22. times the height of the slope is 12 times sine of theta, which is 42 degrees, and times sine of, here we have the difference between the slope angle, which is 64 minus 42 degrees, right? And we have this additional component where we have friction angle, so that's going to be tangent of friction angle, which is 33 degrees, and divide by the tangent of the inclination of the failure plane, which is 42 degrees, which is actually a little bit high. So it's actually higher than the friction angle, right? So I did some calculations. I will tell you that this component, let me look at my notes. So this component will give us value of 0.272, and this one will give us the value of 0.72. So altogether it's 0.992. Well, this is actually very interesting number, 0.992. So you know that if safety factor is greater than 1, then we consider that slope stable. If it's less than 1, we consider it's unstable. So this one is 0.992. Technically it's less than 1, but I believe we can approximate it to 1. So, but 1 means that it's critical conditions. So we still assume that it's stable, like marginally stable, but if something happens, a little bit happen, like a little bit of water or something else, that stability of the slope may decrease, and then this slope may become unstable and maybe we can see some movement of the block, right? So from my experience, I would probably say that this slope is in critical conditions. So we'll probably need to be careful later on when we design measures how to either prevent the slide or do something about it, right? Another thing that I would like to discuss here, the effect of cohesion. If we have cohesion equal to 0, so you see that this component will be gone. And if the cohesion is gone, then safety factor will become equal only 0.72. So this one is unstable. So when it's unstable, this means that we can expect some movement or even a failure. Okay, so that's it about this method, how to use it. I showed you some a simplified formula, how to estimate safety factor for block failure. Have a nice day. Bye.